Hello from the Bureau of Meteorology with an update on Tropical Cyclone Debbie. Well, Cyclone Debbie reached Category 2 strength overnight and now has sustained winds near the centre of 100 kilometres per hour with wind gusts up to 140 kilometres per hour. And the system has now started to adopt that west-south-westwards track towards the Queensland coast and is currently forecast to reach severe Category 3 intensity later this afternoon. So communities between Cairns and St Lawrence are urged to prepare now to make for the cyclone to make landfall on Tuesday. Now, based on the current modelling, the most likely scenario is for the cyclone to make landfall between Townsville and Bowen as a severe Category 4 system. And that has wind gusts around the centre or near the centre of up to 260 kilometres per hour. So we now have a warning in place from Eyre to St Lawrence, and that's because gale force winds are expected to develop about the exposed coast and islands between Eyre and Mackay during this afternoon or evening and could extend further south to St Lawrence tonight, and may increase to destructive winds with gusts over 125 kilometres per hour as early as Monday morning. Now, it's possible that we'll see severe flash flooding around parts of the northern and central Queensland coast and adjacent inland areas from later tonight. And areas of heavy rain are expected to develop, and this threat continues through Monday and Tuesday. Now, the rainfall comes off the back of significant recent rain around Mackay, where catchments are already susceptible to flooding. So a flood watch is in place for coastal catchments between Cairns and Gladstone, and that is also extending inland to the eastern Gulf rivers. And abnormally high tides and large waves remain a risk from at least Lucinda to Mackay as the cyclone approaches the coast. Now, the cyclone track maps are updated every 3 hours at the moment, so remember to always be checking the Bureau's website and app for the latest cyclone forecast and warning information. And please remember to follow advice from local authorities if you're in North Queensland.